Hi, my name is Akansha Agrawal. I work as a child psychologist at Astral Blue Jays. I take behavior modification therapy. So what is behavior? Behavior is anything that can be seen, observed or measured, like greeting someone, saying hi, bye, helping someone. It involves verbal as well as non-verbal behavior. Now, what is behavior modification therapy? Behavior modification therapy involves taking an undesirable behavior, unacceptable behavior, or unwanted behavior and replacing that with a more desirable and more acceptable behavior. It involves skill training, cognitive training, brain training, social training, emotional training, and all of these targets are achieved by practicing it in play, involving games, activities, which in turn helps in increasing the child's sitting tolerance, increasing attention, increasing cognitive ability, and removing the problem behavior. Some of the most common behavioral issues that the parents come with is excessive talking, excessive crying, not listening to instructions, not complying to commands, hitting, biting, throwing temper tantrums. So these are the issues that we take care of in behavior therapy. Now, every behavior serves a function. So there are two things to remember. First is, what is the child getting from doing that behavior? Is he getting attention? Is he getting his favorite toy? Is he getting his favorite food? Second thing is, what is he getting out of or avoiding to do by doing that behavior? For example, avoiding punishment, avoiding consequences, or avoiding doing a task, doing a chore, doing homework. So keeping in mind that every behavior serves a function, you have to pay attention to your child's behavior. To take behavior therapy, we do something called functional behavioral analysis. In this, we do three things. First is defining the problem behavior clearly. See how the behavior sounds like, how it looks like. Second is, what the child is getting from doing that behavior or what the child is avoiding by doing that behavior. And the third is what the child is doing before the behavior is happening, which we call as antecedent, and what is happening after the behavior, which we call as consequence. Keeping all this in mind, keeping the situation in mind, you can analyze why your child's behavior is occurring and how you can handle the behavior. How I take my session is, the session is of 45 minutes. So the usual protocol is, before the session, I will talk to the parents for 10 minutes, taking an update about what they did at home, for which I will share home exercises. During the session, I'll play the games and activities with the child. And after the session, 10 minutes, providing the future target goals, parents can work with the child at home. I want to share 5 key strategies for positive parenting. First is positive one-on-one time with your child. In this, you have to spend 5 to 10 minutes every day with your child doing some fun activity in which you are not scolding the child, not teaching the child, and just spending time with the child. This will help build a positive relationship between you and your child, and it will want to make your child to want to do good behavior. Second is praise. Every time your child gives a positive behavior or a desirable behavior, let them know by praising. You can always use words like, "Oh, you did so well. I really appreciate it. I'm so happy." Third is ignoring annoying but not dangerous behavior. Every time your child does a behavior that you don't want, do not give attention. Instead, you can ignore it and you can pay attention when the child is doing positive or wanted behavior. Fourth is rewards and incentives. Rewards and incentives should be immediate and should be given right after the desirable behavior to let the child know that the child has done something right. So you can use rewards like a day out in the park or a movie night or a chocolate, anything that the child likes. Fifth and last is consequences, which is timeout and withdrawing privileges. What the timeout means is you are timing out from giving attention to the child. Means if the child has behaved badly, you are not giving attention for the next 1 hour or the or depending on how your and your child's relationship is. And second is withdrawing privileges, like taking off TV, taking off mobile phone, anything or anything that the child likes, you can take it from the child to let the child know that he has behaved badly. So here at Astral Little Blue Jays Child Development Center, we have a team of professionals comprising of early interventionists, pediatric physiotherapist, speech language pathologist, special educator, occupational therapist, and behavior therapist. So if you're having any trouble with your child in managing his behavior or any other issue, visit us, we are here to help you.